Looking at this sign, you would definitely think the Kelpies was to your left. Don't believe everything you see.
Beyond the Kelpies, there is lots more to see here at Helix Park. Owls, cairns, centaurs, even unicorns. But we are here at night to discover the dark side of the Kelpies.
This impressive sculpture behind me is the Kelpies here in Scotland, designed by Scottish artist Andy Scott and erected in 2013. Duke and Baron behind me are Clydesdale horses. These are built in galvanised steel, weighing in at 300 tonnes apiece. Stood at an impressive 30 metres tall, that's 100 feet. The Kelpies are ginormous. I'd say you'd have to be here to appreciate their size. But look at me, and look at them, massively impressive.
But what is a Kelpie, I hear you ask? Kelpies are no ordinary horses. In Scottish folklore, they are water shape-shifting creatures that can transform into the form of a horse whilst on land, looking for prey. And my sinister interpretation of the artist's work, combined with the myth, is thus. The Kelpies are erected in Grangemouth, an industrial port town notorious for smouldering flames and toxic fumes up into the sky, and more importantly, down into the banks of the River Forth. The Kelpies, in vengeance for contaminating their natural habitat, lure men, those responsible for the pollution, by transforming into handsome, strong, white stallions with long, glorious, thick manes and tempt those men onto their backs, bearing towards the river only to plunge into a watery grave, drowning them in a sinister act of revenge. Of course, the Kelpies themselves is a great day out for all the family. You are in fact unlikely to get butchered by murderous horses.
Been dreaming of, oh, sympathy.